sucker down into such darkness. Oh, it's going to be terrible, man. And it's right there around the corner, man. A lot of you people still believe in America, man. The Lord's going to cause that place to stink. And you're going to truly know that it's the end. Oh, the end is nigh. This is Job 12 and 22. It says, he discovereth the deep things out of darkness and bringeth out to light the shadow of death. He increaseth the nations and destroyeth them. You see what's happening. At one time, America was the world's breadbasket. And now America's agriculture is struggling out here. Because the Lord is plaguing that land. Right? He's plaguing America, man. Right? With drought, fungus, all different type of disease. Everything just destroying the crops. And it's only going to get worse. Right? He increaseth the nations and destroyeth them. He enlargeth the nations and straighteneth them again. All right? They're going to start losing footholds. Right now, China's is threatening Taiwan. Don't be surprised if you hear more coming out of Libya. All right? America's going to start losing. They're going to start looking weaker and weaker. And if their back is going to get put against the wall. And what that's going to do is it's going to embolden their enemies, right? But what it's also going to do is going to make them have to lash out. And that's going to cause this World War III. Because America is going to be backed against the wall, right? Weakened, okay? And so they're going to go all out. Just like the Israelis are being weakened by the second in the Middle East. The Israelis are not gaining power in the Middle East. They're losing power. They're losing advantage. They had the advantage. They had the power. That's why the scripture says, let the weak say I'm strong. Because America and Israel, they're not getting stronger. They're getting weaker and their enemies are getting stronger. And that dynamic is going to lead to war. Because again, it emboldens the enemy and it puts you in a position where you have to fight while you still got strength in you. So while they still got strength in them, they're going to have to fight. All right? That's why the Israelis are so skittish. That's why they keep threatening Iran, because they see that their enemies in the Middle East are getting stronger. They tried to take out Syria and it didn't work. All right? This is all playing into the Lord's algorithm, right? He enlargeth the nations and straighteneth them again. He taketh away the heart of the chief of the people of the earth and causes them to wander in the wilderness where there is no way. They grope in the dark without light, and he maketh them to stagger like a drunken man. See, America's going to make all the wrong decisions. Every decision they make from here on out, we're ultimately the entire history of America, every decision that they have made is going to lead to their ultimate destruction. And it ain't going to matter what they do. Everything they do is going to backfire. It's going to turn on them. Okay? Every time they try and be slick, every time they think they're making a wise decision, it's going to turn against them. All right? It's a beautiful thing, and we're watching it, man. We're watching the fall of the Lord. Has got this place looking crazy. It's all happening, man, on every level. On every level. Yeah? Destruction. So Isaiah 47 and 1. Come down and sit in the dust, O virgin daughter of Babylon. Sit on the ground, there is no throne, O daughter of the Chaldeans. For thou shalt no more be called tender and delicate. Take the millstones and grind the meal, uncover thy locks, make bare the leg, uncover the thigh, pass over the rivers. Thy nakedness shall be uncovered, yea, thy shame shall be seen. I will take vengeance, and I will not meet thee as a man.